Yep,
Ian, and today we have...
Get up!
Back in.
While playing, you sometimes take screenshots with every opened, probably because you failed to find the F2 button, but anyways, the idea is to take all those screenshots and feed them into a program that will parse coordinates and map those images on a map. Maybe only your screenshots is not enough data for something interesting to happen, but if you are playing on a server and you ask all your friends to send their screenshots folders, plus to that you can download all tours and progress updates from YouTube. Now you will be able to look at the server map and see image icons everywhere showing areas from first person and from different time periods. So first up, you'll need to visit the settings tab. For text recognition to work, images need to be prepared. This program crops and binarizes them, so text becomes black and everything else becomes white. For that, here you will need to enter pixel coordinates of top left corner of F3 coordinates. Yeah, I didn't really know how to automate this step. Let me show you in paint.net how to do that. Just open screenshot with debug screen, zoom in and hover over the needed place. And here are the coordinates of a given pixel in the bottom right corner. Let's actually do box selection, and then you'll also find selection height parameter in the bottom left corner. After you entered your pixel coordinates and height of cropping area, you'll need to find binarization threshold. Back to paint.net, if I choose color picker tool and click on the text, I'll get an RGB value of the pixel, and that's exactly the threshold I'll use to binarize my screenshots. Now let's go back to processing tab and open an image, press crop and binarize, and if everything looks good, get text. And if not, you can always take the settings. You'll see some debug information at the bottom of the screen, as well as parse text. Now let's open map tab. Since I didn't really know how to make dynamic Minecraft map from seed or from level file, I have a bot block here for now. So if you want to help me and if you know how to do it in C#, we'll be glad to receive that help. Anyways, you should get map from some external site or program and paste it in here as an image. You'll have to enter its coordinate range by hand, sadly, but now you should be able to press add markers button, and if marker exists in a given coordinate space, it should be displayed. And yes, as you can see, we actually got it. Let's now do something a bit more interesting. So I downloaded duck tour and rendered it as PNG sequence. Now we can select batch processing in this menu and find folder with PNG sequence of a whole video. When choosing this option, it will not display anything on the screen, it will process all those screenshots in the background. It's also using multiple threads, so it should be relatively fast. After it's done processing, the program will finally unfreeze, because I'm a pro programmer that puts heavy task on a button. So after it finally unfroze, we can go to map tab and press add markers button, and as you can see, it worked pretty well. I also added an option to export marker data with this button. It will generate TXT file in your directory that you can later use to display those markers in some better web application. This program is in a pretty raw state for now, but if you have some ideas how to improve this further, please leave them in the comments. On GitHub I wrote a small documentation so you don't get lost in this project, and if you encountered some bugs, please leave an issue. Some updates on the stuff I've been busy with, well, last summer, but I didn't really make content since then, so that's still news. So I started collecting deleted or unlisted content of old Minecraft players on my main channel in a form of playlists. For that I was searching for URLs, looking for Wayback Machine, trying to find old re-uploads on Bilibili and stuff like that. Therefore, if you have some free time this weekend, you have a lot of nostalgic content to look through. In addition to that, I tried documenting development of some Minecraft machinery in this history tab. New players often reinvent old stuff or totally miss some important events, so this is also something I recommend to look through if you have some free time. For now it's a work in progress, so it's nowhere near being done, but some playlists are more or less finished, and you can find some surprising information in there. For example, this Flameless Stage playlist. It was a common knowledge thinking that cobras were invented by Daniel Cortez and other Zipcron guys, but it's not entirely true. Infinite Piston Bridges existed like a year before. Peter Jung showed Upwards extension half a year before. Not only that, but I managed to find forums where people were developing flying machines even before Redstone update. So yeah, go educate yourself, and obviously if you have some additions to those playlists, please message me on Discord or somewhere else, maybe on Tinder. Okay, I'm done.